Subscribe IN News English YouTube channel to all the big news of the world. The MUTO introduced in Godzilla, King of the Monsters is the strongest of her kind, which puts her above the male and female MUTOs that Godzilla killed in the 2014 movie. She was the third member of her species to appear on the big screen in the MonsterVerse. In 2014 Godzilla, the King of the Monsters rose out of the depths of the ocean to hunt two giant monsters called MUTOs, massive unidentified terrestrial organisms. Lured out of hiding by their hunger for radiation, the MUTOs came to the surface and caused much destruction and chaos for the humans, who looked desperately for ways to beat them. In the end, it took Godzilla to dispose of both MUTOs. After killing the male MUTO, Godzilla sought out the female and separated her head from its shoulders by blasting atomic breath down her throat. Though it seemed that this was the end for their species, a third MUTO emerged in Godzilla, King of the Monsters, allowing their kind to live on in the MonsterVerse. This third MUTO, which briefly served Ghidorah as one of his many minions, switched her allegiance to Godzilla along with Rodan, Methuselah, Behemoth, and Scylla at the end of the movie when he prevailed over Ghidorah. Very little was said about this creature in the movie, but by close inspection, it's apparent that it's a female with a slightly different design. Also, comments from King of the Monsters director Mike Doherty indicate that she's physically superior to Godzilla's MUTOs. Doherty, who has nicknamed the creature Barb, has explained that she's the Queen MUTO, and that she's different and older than the other two. Apparently, the crown of ridges on her head was meant to symbolize her royal status. Being the queen of the MUTOs, it makes sense that she'd be above all other members of her species, and that if she were to fight Godzilla, she could put up a better fight against him than the ones featured in Godzilla, King of the Monsters. Even so, this MUTO can now be counted as an ally to Godzilla in the future and shouldn't be deemed as a threat. Despite being a queen, she doesn't seem to be opposed to bowing down to a stronger titan. Godzilla's victory over Ghidorah made it too clear to all titans that present that Godzilla is the most powerful of them all. Having the strongest MUTO in the MonsterVerse as a minion could be important later on down the line for Godzilla. She could use her strength to aid him in the struggles to come. The MUTO queen could do her part and more to help him if and when he finds himself in a difficult situation in future MonsterVerse installments, such as Godzilla vs. Kong. With a monster war on the horizon, Godzilla could need allies like the third MUTO fighting at his side.